Hello everyone, welcome back to our YouTube channel Alisha Mahes Classes. So today I am going to start chapter number 10 of class 11th. Chapter number 10 is straight lines and we are going to do exercise 10.2 from question number 12 onwards. In our previous video, we have discussed about first 11 questions of this exercise 10.2. So those who have not watched that video, please click on the I link. You can get the description over there for that video. So without wasting the time, let's start question number 12. First of all, read the question. Find the equation of a line that cuts off equal intercept on the coordinate axis and passes through the point 2, 3. So here I have drawn a figure for that. So let us suppose this AB is a line and intercepts means equal intercepts on the axis means this is x-axis and this is y-axis. Coordinate axes are x-axis and y-axis. Now when this line is cutting the both axes, the intercepts are same. So that means if it is cutting the x-axis at 3 units, that means it is cutting the y-axis at also same 3 units. And it is actually passing through the point 2, 3. So for this equation, as intercepts is given, so we will use the equation of line in intercept form. So let's see how we will write down equation of line in intercept form is. In intercept form, we have discussed all the forms of equations of lines in our previous video also. So those who have not watched that video, the description is given in the description link. You can get the link over there to understand the various forms of equations of line, in which one is intercept form we have discussed. So this is intercept form, x upon a plus y upon b is equal to 1. But has here intercepts are equal, so that means here a is equal to b. So this implies the equation becomes x upon a plus y upon a is equal to 1. This implies taking the LCM a, it becomes x plus y is equal to 1. Or we can say that x plus y is equal to, this a is here dividing here. So when we will shift it here, it becomes 1 into a, that is a. Now it is also given in the question that this line is passing through the point 2, 3. Line is passing through 2, 3. Mark this equation as 1. So just put x is equal to 2 and y is equal to 3 in equation 1. So we get the answer. X is 2 and y is 3. So that means a is equal to 5. Now what you have to do, you have to put, a is equal to 5 in equation 1. So the equation of line is x plus y is equal to 5. This is our answer. So students, let's see question number 13. Find the equation of a line passing through the point 2, 2. Now it is related with the previous question. Find the equation of line passing through the point 2, 2. Now this is actually passing through any point 2, 2 and cutting off the intercepts on the axis whose sum is 9. Now it is cutting the coordinate axis and it whatever the intercepts it is making with x axis and y axis, the sum of the intercept is equal to 9. That means we can assume here that a plus b is equal to 9. Now first of all, you have to understand whenever the form of intercept, whenever the line of intercept form is given in the equation, then you have to form the intercept form of equation of line, that is x upon a plus y upon b is equal to 1. So equation of line in intercept form is x upon a plus y upon b is equal to 1, where a is the intercept with the x-axis and b is the intercept with the y-axis. Now it is given that sum of intercept is equal to a plus b is equal to 9. This is given in the question that sum of the intercept is equal to 9. Now first mark this equation as 1 and mark this equation as equation 2. Also it is given that this line is passing through the point 2, 2. So that means equation 1 is passing through 2, 2. Now, if it is passing through the point 2, 2, that means point 2, 2 will satisfy this equation. So, we will put x is equal to 2 and y is equal to 2 in equation 1. What do we get? 2 upon a plus 2 upon b is equal to 1. 2 upon a plus 2 upon b is equal to 1. Cross multiply, taking the LCM, we get 2b plus 2a is equal to 1. This implies 2a plus 2b is equal to ab into 1 is going to be ab. Now what you have to do, from this equation you can take the value of b is equal to 9 minus a and mark this equation as 2. Now please put the value of b is equal to 9 minus a here. So what does it become? 9 minus a, and you will write down use equation 2, because here we have used the value of b is equal to 9 minus a. Solving this equation, we get 2 into 9 is 18 minus 2a is equal to a into 9 is going to be 9a minus a into a is going to be a square. 2a will be cancelled by 2a, a square will be shifted to left hand side, it becomes positive, 9a becomes negative and 18 becomes positive. Now we have to make the factors, and making the factor we get a minus 6, a minus 3 is equal to 0. So that means a is equal to 6 or a is equal to 3. Now it is very simple. When a is equal to 6, then of course, if a is equal to 6, then 9 minus 6, that means b is equal to 3. So therefore, equation of line in this case will be x upon a is here 6 and y upon 3 is equal to 1. So this one can be the equation of line. Or when a is equal to 3, then definitely if we will put a is equal to 3, then b is equal to 6. So in this way, equation of line is x upon 3 plus y upon 6 is equal to 1. You can see one thing is that the sum of the intercept in both the cases is equal to 9. You can take the LCM also, and it becomes 3 into x become 3x, 6 into y becomes 6y is equal to 6, 3 the 18, 1 the 18. And this way you can take 3 common. So the answer will be x plus 2y is equal to 6. This one can be the equation of line. And the secondly, you can solve this equation also. Just take cross multiply. 6x plus 3y is equal to 3, 6 the 18, 1 the 18. I have just taken here LCM and solving this equation. Now again you can see that 3 can be cancelled from both sides. So the answer is 2x plus y is equal to 6. So these are actually the two equations which satisfies the given condition. So students, let's see question number 14. Find equation of line through the point 0, 2 and making angle 2 pi by 3 with the positive x-axis. So first of all, just understand the first part. In the first part, what is given? We have to find equation of line which is passing through one point, and regarding the slope, theta is given. So all of you know that we can find out m, that is slope, with the help of the formula m is equal to 10 theta. So that means we will use point slope form, because point is given and slope we can easily find out by using this angle 2 pi by 3. So very simple question. First of all, read the first part only. Then we will move on to second part. So here theta is equal to 2 pi by 3. That is, if you will change into radians, that is 120 degree. You have done in third chapter how to change in radians. For radians, we will multiply it by 180 by pi. Pi will be cancelled by pi, and it is 2 into 60 is going to be 120. So it can be written as 120 degree. Now, slope is given by the formula m is equal to 10 theta. So this implies m is equal to 10 120 degree, and 10 120 degree can be written as 10 90 plus 30. Or it can be written as simply 180 minus 60. It can be written in both the ways, so you can write down either of the way, your answer is going to be same. So here m is equal to, now you must know the logics of chapter number 3 for this. 10 180 degree minus theta, here theta is lying in the second quadrant, 120 degree is lying in the second quadrant, and in second quadrant 10 is negative, so it is equal to minus 10 60 degree. and the value of 1060 degree is root 3. So therefore slope we get it. We get slope is equal to minus root 3. So we can easily find out equation of line passing through. Now the point is given. Point is this point 0, 2, and m is equal to minus root 3 is, what is the formula? We have discussed this formula also. This is y minus y1 is equal to m into x minus x1. This is actually the point slope form. Point and slope is given. Just put the value. This is point x1, y1. So y1 is 2. M is minus root 3. And x1 is here 0. So y minus 2 is equal to minus root 3x. This can be shifted to the left hand side. So it becomes root 3x plus y minus 2 is equal to 0. Now, this is the first part we have done. Moving on to the second part, also find the equation of line parallel to it. We have to find another equation which is parallel to this equation and crossing the y-axis at a distance of 2 units below the origin. Just understand this concept. This is origin and the line is crossing the y-axis. It is crossing the y-axis 2 units below the origin. Below means the negative y-axis. On negative y-axis, you know that the point will be, the value of x will be 0. And it is 2 units below, so the point will be 0 minus 2. So here actually the point is not given exactly, we have to understand. Now, line is parallel to equation, we can call this equation as 1. Now we know that whenever two lines are whenever two lines are parallel, then their slope are equal. So here we use the same slope. This implies slope is equal to minus root 3 in this case also, because whenever two lines are parallel, you can see slope are equal. So you can take the slope same, minus root 3. Now line is crossing, or we can say cutting the x-axis, crossing the y-axis at a distance of 2 units below the origin. So this implies that it is passing through the point 0, minus 2, I have explained. Therefore, equation of line is passing through 0, minus 2, and the slope will be same, that is minus root 3. So again use the same formula, y minus y1 is equal to m into x minus x1. So here y1 in this case will be minus, sorry, this is 2 units below the origin, so this is going to be 0, minus 2. Minus minus will become plus. M is here minus root 3, x minus x1 is here 0. So it becomes y plus 2 is equal to minus root 3x. So when it will be shifted to here, it becomes root 3x plus y plus 2 is equal to 0. So you can see here the coefficient of x and y are same in both the equations. So please remember this thing, whenever two lines are parallel, the coefficient of x and y is same always. So students, question number 15 is, the perpendicular from the origin to a line meet it at a point minus 2, 9. Find the equation of line. So see here, I have drawn a figure also. This is the perpendicular from the origin on the line AB. This is the perpendicular. I have marked the sign of perpendicularity here. So OP is perpendicular on AB, and this perpendicular is meeting this line on the point P, where P is equal to minus 2, 9. Now we have to find out the equation of line. See students, whenever we have to find out the equation of line, we have to just use your mind whether we can find out point or slope, or we can find out two points from which the line is passing. So in this equation, we can't be able to find out the two points from where equation is passing. So better to think about the slope, because one point is already given in this equation, that this line is passing through minus 2, 9. P is also the point lying on the AB. So that means this line, AB line, is passing through point P. Now we have to think about slope. we can easily find out the slope of line OP. Now, as it is perpendicular, so we can use the concept of perpendicularity of two lines, and we have done this. When two lines are perpendicular, then the slope of their product is equal to minus 1. Yes, we are going to use that concept. So let's see how we will just find out first of all slope of line OP. Slope of OP passing through origin, that is 0, 0, and P point, that is minus 2, 9. So let us take M1 is equal to slope of OP, and we know that the formula to find out the slope when line is passing through two point is given by Y2 minus Y1 upon X2 minus X1. We have done this in our first exercise also. So Y2 is here 9 minus 0 upon minus 2 minus 0. So the answer is going to be minus 9/2. Now we know that OP is perpendicular on AB. So whenever two lines are perpendicular, then slope of their product is equal to minus 1. So let us take slope of AB is equal to M2. Now as they are perpendicular, so this implies M1 into M2 is equal to minus 1. But here we have calculated M1 is equal to minus 9/2. So cancelling negative on both sides, so the value of M2 will be 2 will be shifted here. So it becomes 2/9. So yes, we have found out the slope of the line AB. Very simple. Now we can find out the equation of line AB. Equation of line AB passing through, now as it is passing through point P, that is minus 2, 9, and slope we have find out, slope is equal to 2/9. Just we have find out here slope is equal to 2/9 and passing through minus 2, 9. So the formula is same, y minus y1 is equal to m into x minus x1. Y minus 9 is equal to m is 2/9 into x minus, minus minus will become plus. Now just cross multiply, 9 into y is 9y, 9 into 9 81 is equal to 2 into x 2x plus 2 into 2 4. So this implies we can get, shifting this 9y, it becomes minus 9y, minus 81 will become plus 81. So the answer is 2x minus 9y plus 85 is equal to 0. So students, next is question number 16. The length L of a copper rod is a linear function of its Celsius temperature C. In an experiment, if L is equal to 124.942 and when C is equal to 20 and L is equal to 125.134 when C is equal to 110, express L in terms of C. Now first of all, try to understand the question. Question is very simple. These are actually the two points. This is point x1 y1 and this is point x2 y2. Now we have to just find out the equation of line when two points are given. So here we have taken L is represented by x axis and C is represented by y axis. So the points first x1 y1 will be 124.942, 20, and second point will be 125.134, 110. So we just need to find out the equation of line passing through two points. Equation of line passing through x1 y1 and x2 y2 is given by formula y minus y1 is equal to m into x minus x1. This is the same formula, but we know that m is given by the formula y2 minus y1 upon x2 minus x1. So this is basically here x1, this is y1, this is x2 and this is y2. So just put the value of x1 y1 and x2 y2. So m is y2 minus y1, that is 110 minus 20 upon x2 minus x1, that is 125.134 minus 124.942 into x minus x1. So x1 is 124.942. So y minus 20 is equal to 110 minus 20 is equal to 90, and 125.134 minus 124 0.942 is going to be 0.192 into x minus 124.942. Now we have to represent L. L is represented by x. So that means we have to find out the value of x in terms of y. So just cross multiply. This will come in the multiplication and this will come in the division. So it becomes 0.192 upon 90 into y minus 20 is equal to x minus 124.942. Now in the next step, we are going to take this x is equal to 0.192 upon 90 y minus 20 plus 124.942. So here we get the answer. Now x is represented by L and y is represented by C. So just change x by L and y by C. We get L is equal to 0.192 upon 90, C minus 20 plus 124.942. So this is our answer. Please note down. So student, this is question number 17. The owner of a milk stall finds that he can sell 980 liters of milk at rupees 14 per liter and 1220 liters of milk at rupees 16 per liter. So whenever two informations are given, that means 2 points are given. Now assuming a linear relationship between selling price and demand. So first of all, on x-axis we have to take selling price and on y-axis we have to demand. Demand, that means liters, selling price means that is cost. We have to find out how many liters he could sell at rupees 17 per liter. So after making the equation, we will put this value. So let us see first of all how to find out the equation. So let us take, first of all we have to assume a linear relationship between selling price. So first of all, let us take SP is represented by x-axis. SP is represented by x-axis and demand is represented by y-axis. So the points will be, first of all, selling price. What is the selling price in the first case? It is 14 rupees and the demand is 980 liters. And the second point is, here SP is 16 rupees and the demand is 1220 liters. So very simple, same as the previous question. These are the 2 points. This is x1 y1 and this is x2 y2. So the equation of line is given by y minus y1 is equal to m into x minus x1, where m is equal to y2 minus y1 upon x2 minus x1. Same formula we are using in every question whenever we have to find out the equation of line passing through 2 points. So y minus y1 is 980 is equal to m is, we have to calculate here, y2 is 1220 minus 980 upon x2, that is 16, x1 is 14 into x minus x1 is 14. Now just simplify it. Y minus 980 is equal to, we have to subtract these two and we will get 240 upon 2 into x minus 14. So y minus 980 is equal to, 2 can be cancelled by this, we get 120 into x minus 14. Now in this question we have to find out how many liters, that means we have to find out the value of y when cost is rupees 17 per liter. So x is given, on x-axis we are taking the cost, that is selling price. So when x is equal to rupees 17 per liter, so this is equation, from equation 1 we will just find out the value of y. So y minus 980 is equal to 120 into 17 minus 14. So y minus 980 is equal to 120 into 17 minus 14 is going to be 3, and in the next step we get y minus 980 is equal to 120 into 3 is going to be 360. So y is equal to 360 plus 980. So the demand is 8 into 6 is 14 and this is 1340. Therefore demand is 1340 liters. This is our answer. Please note down. So students, let's see question number 18. P point AB is the midpoint of a line segment between the axes. So between the axes, that means coordinate axis. This is the line AB and P is the midpoint of this line between the axes. So we have to show that the equation of line is x upon a plus y upon b is equal to 2, where p is the midpoint of this line. So we will just suppose that this is cutting the x-axis and y-axis. So if it is cutting the x-axis, so that means point will be x, 0, and on y-axis the point will be 0, y. So it is very simple question. Let's see. Let AB be the line cutting, so this is cutting x intercept and y intercept on x axis and y axis respectively. So as we used to take in intercept form a and b, but it is actually given in the question, so we are using x and y. So these are the intercepts in the equation. Now P is the midpoint of AB. So if P is midpoint of AB, coordinates of P by using midpoint formula. Coordinates of point P will be given by midpoint formula is x1 plus x2 by 2 and y1 plus y1 by 2. So x1 is x and x2 is 0, x plus 0 by 2 and y1 is 0, y2 is y, y1 is 0 and y2 is y by 2. So very simple, coordinates of P is A, B. Just compare x upon 2 is equal to A and y upon 2 is equal to B. So that means x is equal to 2A and y is equal to 2B. So that means here this intercept is 2A and this y intercept is actually 2B. So now we know that in intercept form we are having equation of line. Equation of line will be x upon a, where a is the intercept with x axis, but here this line is making intercept of 2a and with y axis it is making the intercept of 2b is equal to 1. So using intercept form, next is very simple, we can take 1 by 2 common. So 1 upon a, 1 upon 2 common, it will become x upon a plus y upon b is equal to 1. In next step 2 is dividing, so we'll just shift it and we get the answer, that is x upon a plus y upon b is equal to 2 into 1 is going to be 2. So this is the equation we need to prove. Please note down. Students, now move on to question number 19, that is point R h comma k divides a line segment between the axes in the ratio 1:2. Find the equation of line. So student, first of all try to understand the question very carefully. Here it is given about that point R divides a line segment between the axes. Between the axes, that means between the coordinate axes. And whenever this is given, that means you have to take the intercept form of equation of line. So you can see in this figure that this is the intercept form. AB is the line between the coordinate axes and point R is there on this line, which is dividing the complete line in the ratio 1:2. Please remember this thing, you have to always take 1 from the x-axis, so 1:2, not from here 1:2, otherwise your answer will be incorrect. So 1:2, that means from the x-axis, from this distance, this is x and this is 1 and this is actually 2. So we have to find out this equation of line. So let us take that the point A will be A, 0, that's why, that, or we can say that this is A or this is distance B. So that we can use the formula of intercept form of equation of line. So see the solution. Solution 19. let A point will be A comma 0 and B point will be 0 comma B. So in this way, equation of line AB will be given by formula, that is intercept form, x upon A plus y upon B is equal to 1. Now we just have to find out the value of A and B here. So for simplification, I am writing down A. Here A point is A comma 0, B point is 0 comma B, and R point is there in between, whose coordinate is S comma K, and it is dividing the line AB in the ratio 1:2. So now whenever ratio is given, that means we have to use the section formula, very simple. So therefore, by using section formula, the coordinates of R will be given by 1 into 0 plus 2 into A, that is 2A, upon 1 plus 2, that is 3, you can write down in the next step, 1 into B plus 2 into 0. First of all, you have to multiply with the x coordinate to find out x coordinate, and then we have to multiply by y coordinate. Same upon 1 plus 2, because the formula is m1 x2. But here coordinate of R is h comma k. So this is point h comma k, and this is equal to 2a upon 3 comma b upon 3. Comparing this, we get 2a upon 3 is equal to h, and b upon 3 is equal to k. So we get a is equal to 3h upon 2 and b is equal to 3k. So just put this value in equation 1, we will get the answer. From equation 1, we get x upon, the value of A is equal to 3h upon 2. So value is 3h upon 2. We will put 3h upon 2 plus y upon 3k is equal to 1. Shifting this 2 in the numerator, it becomes 2x upon 3h plus y upon 3k is equal to 1. 1 by 3 can be taken as the common. So 2x upon h plus y upon k is equal to 1, or we can shift this 3 in the multiplication. So just it becomes this equation. So the answer is 2x upon h plus y upon k is equal to 3. This is our required answer. So students, next is question number 20. By using the concept of equation of line, we have to prove that these three points are collinear. So what do we do? By using the first two points, we can find out the equation of line. So without wasting the time, let's see equation of line passing through these two points, that is 3 comma 0 and minus 2 comma minus 2 is, equation is given by y minus, you can write down for your convenience, this is y x1 y1, this is x2 y2. So the formula is y minus y1 is equal to m, where m is equal to y2 minus y1, that is minus 2 minus 0, upon x2 minus x1, that is minus 2 minus 3, into x minus x1, that is x minus 3. So y is equal to minus 2 upon minus 5 into x minus 3. Minus will be cancelled by minus. We get 5y is equal to 2 into x minus 3. This is our required equation. Now we have to prove that this point lies, if these points are collinear, see here, collinear means all the points will lie on the same line. So these are the three points. So by using these two points, we have found out the equation of line, and we have to prove this point is also collinear on this line. Simply, we will prove that this point will satisfy this equation. In 10th standard also, you know that when any point lies on the equation of line, that means it will satisfy the given equation. So 8,2, if 8,2 lies on equation 1, then we will first of all find out left hand side is 5y. So put y is equal to, here x is equal to 8 and y is equal to 2. So put y is equal to 2, we get 10. And right hand side is 2 into x minus 3. So 2 into the value of x is 8. 8 minus 3 is 5. So 2 into 5 is equal to 10. So clearly you can see that this point 8 comma 2 satisfies equation 1. Now if it is satisfying equation 1, that means the points, 3 points A, B and C are collinear. Therefore given points are collinear. So this means you can find, you can prove the point collinearity of the points by using equation of line. Please note down. So students, I hope so that you have understood all the questions of this exercise 10.2 that we have discussed today. And in our previous video also, we have discussed the remaining 11 questions. So those who have not seen, they can watch our previous video. Thank you so much for watching Alisha Maths Classes.